Previously, I uploaded a video using the Flux model, where it took 5 seconds for one step and 120 seconds to generate a result. Now it takes 1.3 seconds for a step, and the image generation time was 11 seconds. It was possible by the 4-bit quantization of the diffusion model and uploaded on Hugging Face by this group. And these are the 4-bit Nunchaku models. I will keep it simple. So, first we got the Flux1.dev model, which is a large 24GB model. You need fast graphics cards with bigger memory sizes to load these models and get results from them. Then, a stripped-down version of the same model was released by another guy on the internet, named Flux1dev FP8. The original 24GB model we saw was an FP16 model, and this is an FP8 model, which also worked on my smaller 16GB card. Then the GGUF models were released for graphic cards with memory sizes between 6 and 12 gigabytes. These are quantized models, allowing them to run on smaller graphic cards. Generating images with these models requires a different mathematical approach, which introduces the GGUF nodes. In the GGUF workflow, the standard checkpoint loader and unit loader nodes are replaced by GGUF nodes, while the rest of the workflow remains similar to the original Flux workflow. Similarly, the Nunchaku workflow can remain unchanged, with specific Nunchaku nodes replacing the checkpoint node and the load Lorin node. These models are smaller in size, but they are still capable of producing great images, albeit with some sacrifice in quality. These nodes also rely on a package format called Wheels, which is compatible with Python. In this video, I'll show you how to install and use Nunchaku nodes for Nunchaku models, including two different methods for installing the wheel for Comfy UI. Please note, this setup is for NVIDIA's RTX graphic cards. I do not know if this will work with other cards. I suggest users with cards older than the 3000 series do a separate Comfy UI installation in a different folder. I will begin from the Comfy UI's GitHub page. Links will be in the description. And I have downloaded the Comfy UI Windows portable file. Extract the downloaded file. The files are extracted. Next, I will be installing the Comfy UI Manager. I will copy the link. And you will need Git for Windows to clone the project from GitHub. You can install Git for Windows from here. The installation will be simple. You just need to click Next. Inside the custom node folder, I will type cmd. You can check like this if your Git is installed and working. Now I will type git clone and paste the copied URL. The Comfy UI Manager has been cloned. I will update Comfy UI with the help of this update batch file inside the update folder. The update is done. Now I will start Comfy UI. And this is the default workflow. I downloaded the DreamShaper model to check if it is working. Next, I will go to the manager. In the custom nodes, I will search for Nunchaku. I will install the nightly version and then restart and reload the Comfy UI. Next is to set up the wheels. First, I will show you the easy method, which is with the help of this workflow. I will download the workflow and open it inside Comfy UI. These two nodes will do the installation and show us the output. Select the source to download the wheels. I will select Hugging Face. Below is the dropdown to select the version. The 0.3.1 is the latest I selected. Here, I am not sure. As per the documentation, it should show the wheel downloaded for the installation and if it was installed successfully. I ran the workflow, and it took a few seconds to complete. The information given here is about the wheel file downloaded. The node had identified the Python version, Torch package version, and the operating system of my computer to download this file. If the node fails to identify and download a file that is not compatible, then we have to set that manually. It is in the video ahead. Back in the workflow, these are Nunchaku workflows. I will search for context. There are two workflows. Which workflow should I get? This workflow or the one below? I will take this simple workflow to test if it is working. I downloaded the workflow and opened it inside Comfy UI. Model files required in this workflow are missing. These files are used with Flux models. I downloaded the files starting from the VAE in the VAE folder. The clip L will be saved inside the text encoder. I made a folder to avoid confusion. And this T5, which will also be in the text encoder folder. This says the Nunchaku DIT node is missing, and here it does not give an option to install. I updated all the nodes from the manager. If you have multiple custom nodes, then update only the Nunchaku node and then restart and reload. The missing node problem is fixed. I will select the files needed in the workflow, starting from the clip L file. The VAE file. And now I need to get the diffusion transformer model, or I should say the DIT model. Links from this notepad will be shared in the description. And this is the DIT model I will be downloading. The above file is FP4, a different method of quantization compatible with the newer 5000 series cards. I have a 4060, so I will be downloading the INT4 file. Save it inside the diffusion models folder. The folder I create is to avoid confusion. I will also get this Nunchaku version of the Flux 1 dev model. Above is the quantized FP4 for 5000 series cards. I will download the INT4 for my 4000 series card. Refresh the file list by pressing the letter R and select the INT4 context model. The prompt here is about a Pikachu with a sign which says, "Nunchaku is awesome, a yarn style art." I had this evil Pikachu from the last video on Forge UI. I ran the workflow. And the iteration time is 1.48 seconds. Before Nunchaku, it was between 4 and 5 seconds. 20-step generation took 47 seconds, which is not bad. And I like the result. I tried generating an image with 8 steps. It took around 13 seconds, and the result is fine. The text looks lighter than before. My graphics card is slow. A flagship card should give real-time image generation. Let me know your generation time in the comments. Now I will try the workflow with 2 images. The subject here looks good, and you can buzz this user for the image. I searched for the second image, and I found one that should look good on the subject I have. My prompt will be a girl wearing a pink dress, tied knots on her shoulder, posing for a photo. I ran the workflow. The generation was fast, and I got the result in 14 seconds. But the Nunchaku did not work. I think the prompt is correct, but it was not able to point out the dress on the subject. It always gives me the dress on the right and the subject with a pink outfit as specified in the prompt. I do not like the way these nodes are kept. I removed the notes and changed the workflow, which now looks clear to me. In this workflow, the image comes from the right and goes to this section and becomes a condition. I want the girl in the pink dress that is given in the second image. That is my condition, and I do not want anything else to happen. This clip loader with a prompt enters this section, bringing the condition about what I asked for. Then everything goes to case sampler. So I can say that this part is correct because I need to put information from both images. At the same time, I'm sending information about both images to the case sampler as a latent space. The preview image is what I am giving to the case sampler as a canvas to draw the result. This is where it gets confused. I should be giving only one image to K-Sampler as a canvas to draw the result. This will avoid confusion to the AI, and there will be only one object in the latent space to focus on. To do that, I will copy these two nodes, make some space here, and paste them. Now I will be giving only one image in the latent space to draw the final result. The VAE encode node uses the VAE to change the image from pixel space to the latent space. And I got the result. A couple things have been changed. The rest looks fine. What do you think about these Nunchaku models? Are you using these models? I tried to generate with 8 steps, and it looks like an undercooked, but it is going in the correct direction. The Flux Schnell model will be blazing fast with this 4-bit quantization. Generation with 15 steps does not work either. 20 steps give a good result with this 4-bit context model. Let's look at some other Nunchaku nodes. Similar to the GGUF text encoder, this Nunchaku text encoder node will replace the normal text encoder. I will select the clip.l file, and then the T5 file. Make the connection, and let's check if it gives a similar result. One of her legs looks wrong. Now the character has changed completely. I think I should use the Nunchaku text encoder instead of the T5, which is for the original Flux model. This INT4, which is a T5 file, is a Nunchaku text encoder. I will save it inside the text encoder folder, and I make this folder to avoid confusion. Press the letter R to refresh and select the file and generate. Now this message just flashed. I saw it for like maybe a few milliseconds. I was in the middle of dragging the workflow and was heading towards the Save Image node to see the result. I was unable to understand what happened, and then I clicked the Run button again. Then it worked. This out-of-memory error I noticed later. After I clicked the Run button, the image generation was in progress. So I continued recording the video and got the result with the knots on her shoulder. One more thing I forgot to cover in the previous video. You can do a right-click on the image, open the mask editor, create a mask of the cloth, and then save the mask. Search for the VAE encode node for InPaint. Make the respective connections, pixel, mask, and VAE. Then send it to the latent space. It may not look useful right now, but when working with a single image, trying to change the hair color of a person, this method should work without affecting other areas, like her face. One more thing I should let you know is you may need to change this data type to Float 16 if your graphics card is older than the 3000 series. This attention can be changed if you have installed Flash Attention. By default, Nunchaku is selected. I have not tested which is better. What else can I cover? Let's add the Lauren node. This Nunchaku Flux Laura should be used with a Nunchaku DIT loader. Make the connections. You can chain multiple such nodes one after another to use multiple LoRAs. This may look off topic, but I will be quick. Apply the filter on Civit AI for the context LoRA. There aren't many LoRA for context yet. I downloaded this LoRA, saved it inside the LoRA folder. Refresh with the letter R, and copy the trigger words. I added the trigger words at the end of the prompt, changing the latent image from the mask to the single image of the character, and click Run to generate. And this is the result. It looks fine. And I can say that the Nunchaku Laura node works. You have to try a few times to get the pose closer to the given image of the girl. I think that is it. Your ideas in the comments are appreciated. Now let's install the wheel manually. I deleted the comfy UI and installed it again with a manager. And I think the workflow was cached in a browser, hence it got loaded even after deleting comfy UI. I got the missing node pop-up, and then I installed it from here. I suggest installing nodes from the comfy UI manager, because this loading icon never stops. I was in a loop, even after restarting comfy UI. It kept giving the same message. I tried updating nodes from the manager like I did before, but nothing changed. I then ignored it and continued the manual installation of the wheel. Your comfy UI is inside this folder, and the Python with the library should be in the second folder. Get inside the second folder. This is the Python executable, and I will use it to set up wheels. Open the CMD in the same folder, and type python.exe hyphen, then letter V. My Python version is 3.12. Now check if pip is available. Pip is Python's package manager. And it is there. The links will be in the description, and here are the wheel files I need to download. Nunchaku 0.3.1 is the latest version. I will do a Control plus F to highlight. Now I need the one that matches my Torch version and the Python version. My Python version is 3.12, so I will be looking at the CP312, that is 3.12. Now I need to check the version of Torch. This command will show all the packages installed and its version. This is the complete list of packages installed. The Torch version is 2.7.1. So, based on this information, I will highlight, and now it narrows down to 6 files. My Python version is here. Both the files are for the same version, but one is for Windows and the other is for Linux. I will open the Windows file, copy the download link. Now type this command and paste the copied link. This will make pip download and install the wheels. And now it says successfully installed. I will close both the command prompt and run comfy UI again. The missing node problem is gone. I tried running the workflow. The files are missing. After I downloaded all the files, it worked as it did before. I was trying a few LoRa for testing, but there aren't many that works. The LoRa is not present, but the trigger words were. So, everything is working similarly to what we saw previously. I tried the Flux One dev model. There are 2 LoRa used in this workflow. I will share the link for the LoRa used. This is a 6 GB model, and the first run is taking quite some time. One iteration takes 38 seconds, and the generation time was around 6 minutes. The result looks good, but the text on the board is wrong. I tried running the workflow again, and I got the result in 14 seconds. I tried again and got the result in 6 seconds. Now the text on the board is correct. The image generation speed on my 4060 is crazy. On a flagship card, this should be in a second. Let me know if the video was helpful. Your thoughts and suggestions are very much appreciated.